The cosine outputs the ratio of two lengths, which means that the unit of measurement that the cosine returns is 1. The cosine does not return meters or kilograms, it returns bare numbers. So whatever is in front of that cosine determines the measurement unit of the result. The result is not measured in days. We can immediately reject these. The result is measured in meters. It can only be this one or that one. The cosine and the sine range between -1 and +1. If we multiply by something times 10 to the -9 meters, we would be dealing with very, very tiny lengths. That's not what we are into here. It has to be the first one. This is the radius of the orbit of the moon around the Earth. Let me do these in reverse order. The radius of the orbit of the moon should not appear inside here. This has to do with the period of the moon's orbit. How long does it take the moon to make one full orbit around Earth? 27 days. It must not be the meters. Which is also clear from the units. If we have meters in here, something has to cancel the meters. We have to have an angle in here. If we speak of radians, again, something without measurement units. There must not be any measurement unit in here. If it were meters, these meters would have to cancel somehow. How would I do that? Not with time, obviously. Seconds or days don't cancel with meters. Once we're here, it's clear that we have to use the division. Days divided by days. This gets rid of the measurement unit. We can't multiply by days, otherwise we would be getting days square. And the remaining choice, 2 pi times the time. Not this one, not this one. If we let t grow by 27 days, one complete period, the numerator increases by 2 pi times 27 days. And this ratio increases by 2 pi times 27 days divided by 27 days by 2 pi. As t advances by 1 period, this ratio advances by 2 pi, but that's precisely what we need for cosine and sine. The angle has to advance by 2 pi, 360 degrees, one full revolution.